So here's an advanced topic this week, and we're not going to go into it in a huge amount of detail, and I don't expect you to fully understand it because it is a pretty advanced topic, but it's something that we're going to cover in fair detail in 233W, and I want you to at least be familiar enough with it to recognize it. It has to do with nested functions. So let me go ahead and write a function. And I'll call this create a function. And then I'm going to hit shift enter for multi-line input in the console. And then inside, I'm going to set a local variable called inner function equal to a new anonymous function. And then let's go ahead and console.log my inner function. And then we'll close off that function call. End of the statement. This is declaring and initializing a variable, so it needs a semicolon at the end. And then close off the outer function. And hit return. So what I just did was I created a function called create a function, like so. And when I run it, what it did was it created a local variable called inner function, set it to be a new function, and then it didn't do anything with it. So let's go ahead and make one change. What I want to do is after, whoops. Let's try that one more time. So shift plus enter. I'm going to add a line that returns inner function. So now I have a function that creates a function and returns it. And if I call this function, the return value is this function. And if I want to execute this function, I can do this, for example. So now I have a function called my new function, which I can execute, and it prints my inner function to the console log. I can also use this syntax, like so. So this part here creates and returns a function. And then that part calls it. So it prints my inner function again. So you might say, well, why is this useful? Well, one of the reasons it's useful is because every time you have a function statement, this creates a variable scope, and anything inside of that scope can access the variable that I declare here. So let's go ahead and do something like this. Say function create counter functions. And then we'll go ahead and create a local variable called count, and we'll set it to 0. And then I'm going to create a few functions. But instead of creating them as locals, I'm going to create them as globals. So I'll say, for example, increment counter is equal to function count plus plus. And since there's no var increment counter here, this is setting a global variable called increment counter to be that function. So it'll be defined outside. If there was a var here, it would only exist inside of create counter functions. And then I'm also going to implement decrement counter equals function count minus minus. And I'll do one more get counter. return counter. So now I have a function called create counter functions. And when I execute it, it's going to create a scope with a local variable called count, and then three global functions that can access this variable. So let's go ahead and define it and then call it create counter functions. Now, if I call get counter, counter is not defined. Yeah, it was actually count. Let me clear the console and okay, so here is my code from before. And let me fix this. There. So now I'm going to call create counter functions. And then I'm going to call get counter. All right, so counter is 0. And then I'm going to call increment counter and call get counter again. Now it's 1, 2, 3. And back to 1. So what's going on? And now if I type count, it's undefined. So there's no global variable called count, but I'm sharing this count variable across these three functions. And I can have as many functions as I want that are accessing this variable, and I can have multiple variables. And this actually comes in handy because every time I call a function, it creates a brand new scope and creates any local variables inside of here and initializes them. So there's no way to have a value that persists across multiple function calls unless you create a scope outside of the function and refer to the variable in that outer scope. So you can do this using a global variable, but global variables are bad because code can accidentally step on the value of a global variable and cause a different module in the program to return incorrect results. Here, count is only visible to the three functions that are defined inside of the scope. And so they can share this value. This value will persist across multiple function calls, and I'm immune to some other piece of code outside of here stepping on this value. So this is a common pattern. It's advanced, but it's common. And there's a term for this. This is called a closure. So this scope here is closed over the variable count, where count is inside of this closure. And a lot of languages let you do something like this, but it's really flexible in JavaScript.